little bit of Social Distortion with Johnny Cash's remix of the Ring of Fire. Y'all check that out on our fucking YouTube channel, man. Y'all come on in and subscribe to our YouTube channel, man. Y'all get to see a lot of the songs that we play and shit. Y'all actually get to see the videos, the comedy bits that we play. Get to see the videos on it. And a bunch of other shit we put up on there. So, yeah, come on in.
So I checked that out. The closest point between us and Russia from the West Coast up in Alaska is 53.09 miles.
Damn, that is close.
And there's a there's a small island right in between the two countries.
Right.
And I think that island's actually a neutral island, but I'm not 100% for sure on that. But I mean, that's still pretty damn close considering, you know, the kind of ties that we have currently with them.
Yeah, it's like a fucking Irish drive.
yeah.
If that. So, I want to turn everybody over to the Green Light Network. It's a veterans network. If y'all got any questions on resources and stuff like that, y'all can go to this Facebook page, of the Green Light Veterans, resources. It's pretty much a big ass phone book kind of per se, or a dictionary, if you will, of veteran resources all over the damn place. One of our sisters, Miss Doran, has been working steadily on this for 3 years and, she said they'd be almost completely done by maybe next summer. It goes state specific and nationwide. So, you know, if you're looking for any resources or something like that, y'all can tune into that and check out, you know, resources and stuff. I actually just downloaded the state specific for the Carolinas on resources around here. And, yeah, they do a good job of what they're doing, and everything is vetted. They don't put anything up that's not vetted. So, you know, at least and that's a good thing. It's that way, you know, if you need some help or something like that, you can actually go to these resources and know that, you know, it's vetted resources. You don't have to worry about, you know, them not helping somebody. It's shit, I'm sitting here looking at the South Carolina resources now, dude, and it's pretty fucking long. Against websites.
Let me say something to interject in that real quick, because I've never been to the website. I can't say for sure what it looks like. You're on there right now looking through your state specifically. The problem that I ran into a few years ago when I was having it really rough, I was trying to reach out everywhere for help, and in all honesty, I'm not going to name the groups that I went to on Facebook, but they're very reputable groups that want to help, that are veteran based, that basically wanted to say was, well, go here, and then I would go to where they said to go, and I would get pushed to another site, without getting any honest answers.
Right. Well, that's the good thing about what they do. Like South Carolina right now, that she's got 21 pages.
Damn.
Gives you website links, gives you addresses, gives you phone numbers, fax numbers, and stuff like that. You know, and not saying that the very first one that you call is going to be able to help. They might not, but you know, I'll just give a couple things right here. You got the suicide prevention coordinators. You got Mental Health America of Greenville County. You got the Aiken County Helpline. The United Way Association of South Carolina. You got the VA medical centers in the state of South Carolina. I mean, you know, these are things, you know, some of these people need to know anyway. You know, as they're coming in, transitioning back into to society. These are some of the things that people need anyway. And if they don't have the tools or anything like that, you know, they're right here. You know, you can go on and check it out. But I mean, there's more than just VA stuff on here. You know, got Department of Social Services in case you need help with, you know, your kids or having, you know, issues with, you know, your spouse or whatnot. Housing and urban developments, military home fronts, national government associations, National League of Cities. Hey, it's a bunch of shit on here, man. So y'all, if y'all get a chance, man, go check out that page on Facebook. It's the veteran, it's the Green Light Veteran Resources. You know, it's and you can go through and look and see if they got their state popped up, and check it out. And you can download these pages and stuff. I know what she had put out this morning. It had South Carolina, had Rhode Island, and Puerto Rico resources and stuff on there this morning. I know she is working hard to get all the state-specific stuff out. That's something that's really important to do. The nationwide resources are pretty badass, but you know, need to get into the state-specific, which is pretty cool because that'll lead to a lot more help. And you know, These reputable companies out here, you know, there's a lot of people out here that say they help. You know, but they really don't fucking help. You know, they might do little things here and there, but, you know, I know there's one company out there that says they like to put a lot of their profits towards veteran-owned organizations and businesses, and it's a bunch of bullshit. You know, if you're making something for somebody that costs, you know, $13 and you're going to have to turn around and sell it for $25, the 30, not a lot of people buy this shit, you know, and it's something really basic, you know, and they're trying to make a living off of this at the same time as they're trying to donate back to these organizations. And that's not saying that it's not a good idea, but that's like a second job. If you're going to have something out there that you're making a product of something like that, and you're wanting to donate back into the veteran community, then that should be like your second job. That should be like your hobby. As you come home, you're pushing out this product, and then whatever you're making off of it goes back into the community. Well, you still got to have a job to pay your fucking bills. I mean, that's the part that I don't think these people are quite thinking straight. Oh, well, yep. It's not working, dude. And then they, to get people's attention, oh, I'm shutting it down. Okay, shut it down. I mean, you've been bitching about shutting down for last year, and you come out and said it like 50,000 times, you know, shut it down. I mean, hell, I won't put no names out there either, but just put it this way. I know firsthand for a fact, but, it is what it is. And yeah, it'll be whatnot. Looks like Killer Kirk's going to go on here in a little bit. I find out what time she's going on. She's got something that's very, she says it's very uplifting that she wants to put on the fucking air today, which is pretty cool. Actually kind of curious about what she's going to play. So
I just had something come up on my Facebook. It kind of pisses me off, but this just goes to show the root of how bad the drug epidemic is in my area. And I'm sure it's bad everywhere, but most businesses, and I know this because I talk to a lot of people in my area, most businesses are tied to the drug problem. And not only are some of the businesses tied to the drug problem, but so are some of the police enforcement officers, which is sad. I know actually one right now, he's a highly decorated officer. He's actually being investigated by the local police department. I believe FBI is investigating him as well as a couple other agencies for his connections to drug and prostitution activity. And this is just something that came up in my newsfeed from somebody, I'm not going to put their name out there, from my local community. And it was a long post that was put up, and we have on Facebook, it's instead of following the news from, you know, TV, we'll follow news from this site because the site will actually put out news for our immediate area and stuff that pertains to our community instead of, you know, getting news from somewhere that's an hour away that doesn't get all the news stories and things happening in our area. But this girl put on here, she says, I work midnights at Speedway most of the time alone, which is true. I know this for a fact. Not a good part of town or good time of night to be alone in such an area. How is my boss going to write me up for calling the police at 1:30 in the morning on some dope head that threatens to harm me, parentheses, that was arrested previously for harassment there.
What the fuck?
And has been banned for theft as well, but then wants to call the cops ASAP on a homeless veteran that stole a honey bun. What's really going on? I'm beyond furious. Plus, the hours got cut after my purse got taken because I invaded a thief's privacy by posting a pic. Who's hiring? Now, that's how bad it is in my area. Like I said, I know it's bad everywhere, but this is just one little snippet of things that I've seen from my local community where a lot of, like, the place that she works at, the Speedway, and I know exactly where she's talking, it's in the heart of the city of, you know, where my daughter lives and where I used to live and where most of my family lives at. And at nighttime, I shit you not, you could pull in there and you would have somebody walk up to your car and ask you what you're looking for. Because that's where all the dope heads hang out. Now, the fucked up part is the police know it, yet the police don't stop it.
Right.
They don't try to interject. They don't try to do car searches because, hey, you're loitering on a property. You're not at a pump and you're not inside. They have a legal right. They could pull over next to your car, pull your ass out and search your car because you're technically loitering on in a parking lot.
Right.
And yet, again, like I said, you know, nothing's being done. The owner of the Speedway is being, you know, handed money to stay hush hush, and that's also why he's not pursuing, you know, keeping people off his lot that aren't there to either buy his gas or, you know, buy something out of his fucking store.
All right. Wow. Yeah, that's fucked up. The cops know about it, and they're fucking letting it continue to happen.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Yeah, I'd like to know the answer to that question. What is really fucking going on? I hope she finds a new job. No shit.
I shot her a message, told her I know there's like four places hiring right now, and I shot her the names of all the places. So hopefully she gets something, you know, lined up here soon that, you know, she can jump on and get the fuck out of there and get away from it somewhere where she can actually make some decent money and make a living. Because I worked at a gas station here a while back ago in the town that I live in, which is 20 minutes from where she's at. And the gas station I worked at, the owners deliberately keep shit in stock for people who make meth.
Right.
Now, you know as well as I do, most cars currently, you know, they're fuel injected. You can't use starting fluid on them. But the meth cookers will use starting fluid, lighter fluid, any kind of flammable material that they can get their hands on to help make their meth. Yep. They keep that in stock. They keep coffee filters in stock. And I'm not talking just a few coffee filters, man. I'm talking tons. They buy it every week by the case.
Wow.
Like big-ass boxes in stock just so that these people have the means to make their meth. Why? Well, the way the owner sees it is it's putting money in his pocket. He doesn't care that it's harming his community, but it's putting money in his pocket, and that's all they care about.
Right.
And I've seen the dope dealers pull in, and I've seen it firsthand. A guy pulled in.